election, we will see the Prude take on members of the corporate ministry.
And Terry Taylor standing right now. He's back in the locker room with the Prude.
Prude, back together again side by side. Edge, what's been going on?
The bloodlines that bind become strained from time to time. But once again, all is back in line. The differences with my blood brothers have been resolved. A lack of communication, whatever you want to call it. But with the passing of adversity comes strength.
The fury of the Brood will rage forever.
So beware, take care, because the freaks still come out at night.
We are back live on Sunday Night Heat from the Market Square Arena in Indianapolis. Set for six-man tag team action. And here comes the Brood, Gangrel, Edge, and Christian. And before the break, Kevin, we've been speculating on the fact that perhaps the Brood, there was some dissension within the ranks, but Gangrel and Edge and Christian seem to clear all that up.
And that certainly is going to sit very well for this jam-packed Market Square Arena. Alive and kicking with the Brood's entrance. And talk about alive, what about the awakening of the Big Show? What a way to kick off this hour.
The Big Show making a promise. He was going to take out The Undertaker and Kane, and he may start with the Big Red Machine right here tonight live on Sunday Night Heat.
An athlete the size of the Big Show's, that motivated and that intense. What a dangerous proposition for Kane, who is going to have to face that reality apparently here tonight.
And the Brood together again. Dissension has been cast aside as the Brood gets set for this matchup. A haunting entrance here for the Brood. And Kevin, speaking of haunting,
yeah, I wonder if DreamWorks might have had these three in mind with their latest production.
Welcome to Hell.
A chilling proposition. And talk about chilling, it certainly has been very scary for the fans of the Brood. I'm sure they can all feel much better now that rumors of their problems can be put to rest.
A six-man tag team match now. Boss Man, Visser, and Minion from the corporate ministry set to take on the Brood. And I'll tell you, last week on Raw, Edge with a surprise upset over the Big Boss Man. But in the end, Edge and then Christian paid for it.
I'm sure Edge and Christian are both still sporting rather fresh wounds from the Big Boss Man's nightstick. After the victory, Edge was tied in the ropes. Christian came down to make the save, but he suffered the same fate. And Michael, all the questions pointed towards Gangrel. And why did he not come down to save his Brood brethren from the hands of the beating they received from the Big Boss Man?
So here we go now. It's going to be the Brood against the corporate ministry. The quickness, the agility of the Brood against the strength, the powerhouse of the corporate ministry. Edge now set to lock up with the European champion, Midian.
And it certainly seemed, Michael, that the Big Show, having his own blood drawn from the chair shot for The Undertaker, certainly has awakened the seven-footer in very, very scary proportions.
And we are 2 weeks away from the Big Show, fully loaded from the sold-out Marine Midland Arena in Buffalo, New York. First blood match, Undertaker, Stone Cold for the title with some unique stipulations.
Certainly are. Well, oh! Midian runs right into the boot, and those stipulations are,
wow,
it's the end of an era. It could be in the WWF one way or the other. Either it's going to be Stone Cold's last opportunity at the World Wrestling Federation Championship, or if The Undertaker is victorious, oh, in the first blood match, if Stone Cold is victorious, rather, Michael, we will never see Mr. McMahon in the WWF again.
And look at that now. Midian tossing Christian off, went to the well once too often, and now Midian, who claims to be the European champion, and I guess he is. He took
he
the European belt out of the duffel bag of Shane McMahon, and here comes the 500-pounder Viscera. And look at the size of this man. Nice leg sweep by Midian.
Oh, man!
And a leg drop that time by Viscera. Tell you, this corporate ministry, bigger, badder, stronger than ever. And the big question, the founder of the corporate ministry, one of the founders, The Undertaker, is he back together, reunited with his brother Kane?
Wow. Certainly is a very, and of course the contract negotiations, we'll talk more about what Stone Cold and Mr. McMahon have in store for us tomorrow night on Raw, but we understand Al Snow is in some contract negotiations of his own in the back as Edge hits the spear. Can he do the same to Viscera?
And Edge now hammering away on Viscera. Edge, great young superstar here in the WWF, great double team by the Brood, trying to knock the big 500-pounder off his feet.
Oh,
and another double drop kick. And now Boss Man in the ring, and the Brood now hopping on all cylinders. Edge off the rope now, spinning heel kick. We're looking outside the ring. Viscera just caught Christian. And now he's slamming into that steel post. Edge now top rope, crossbody on Boss Man. Here's a cover now. Referee distracted by Midian. And wait a minute now. Gangrel, what is he doing? Gangrel just impaled Edge in the middle of the ring. Boss Man hooks the leg. What the heck is Gangrel doing? And Boss Man and the ministry pick up the victory with the bigger story. crowd turning his back, delivering an impaler Tez. And this crowd spewing forth venom and hatred towards Gangrel. A shocker here on Heat, folks. We thought the dissension in the Brood was all a gone, that it was put to the side, but Gangrel showing it isn't. Boy, what a shameful situation as far as Gangrel and the Brood are concerned.
Just like
Heat and Gangrel's claims earlier tonight that there are no problems within the Brood were apparently bogus, Kevin.
As Edge, as we're about to see, hit the crossbody on the Big Boss Man. Referee's attention was diverted. Edge apparently getting up to go get him. Gangrel seized upon this opportunity. Drilled his partner at one time with the Impaler. And you can hear the hatred coming from the crowd. They know exactly what Gangrel did.
Yeah, it seems pretty apparent to me, and this was shot during the break just a few moments ago, folks. Gangrel making his way out of the Market Square Arena.
Yeah, this tells me here, Michael, that this was a lone act of rage by Gangrel. There certainly were no corporate ministry motives in this. This was Gangrel doing...